Hello everyone, so yet another interesting video lesson on one of the most important topics for this year mains examination as well, and obviously can be useful for your next year prelims examination and for the general audience as well. It's a landmark verdict given by the Delhi High Court and it relates to the copyright issues. So this is a case regarding the Rameshwari Photocopy service case, and this video will be presented to you by me, Deepanshu Singh. So this is a bit of introduction about me. I have done my BTech in Computer Science Honours from UPW Lucknow. Apart from that, I have been an NTSC topper and a debating champion, and I have appeared for Civil Services and Indian Forest Services mains examination. And my interests are music, cueing, fitness and photography. And do rate, review and recommend this video to your friends. And you can also follow me in an academy on this link to get updates on my videos and on my courses. So this case, basically Delhi High Court dismissed the suit by three international well-known publishers against the sale of photocopied content in Delhi University. And this is one case which got a lot of support from the students as well as the teaching community and teachers association. So what exactly was the issue? So basically this shop, Rameshwari Photocopy Services, is a shop in Delhi University which was selling the compilations of parts of books in the form of course packs to the students. And three publishing houses claimed this to be illegal and in violation of the provisions of the Indian Copyright Act. So they filed, went to court against this. So the parties involved in this case were three publishing houses, as I've already mentioned. They are the biggies of the publication divisions and publication houses, the Oxford, Cambridge and Taylor and Francis. And there were some Indian companies involved as well. But the three major ones are mentioned. And the other one, obviously, the other party is the Rameshwari Photocopy Service, which is located inside the Delhi University. So what was the Delhi High Court's judgment? It's a landmark judgment. And obviously, the afflicted parties have appealed in Supreme Court. So we have to wait and watch on this one. So basically, the Delhi High Court dismissed the copyright infringement petition initiated in August 2012 by the three publishers, which we have mentioned, the Oxford and the Cambridge and the other one. And it's also held that the copyright in a literary work is not an inevitable, divine or a natural right conferred to another. It adds that the copyright law is intended to increase and not impede knowledge. So this was one of the most important lines of the judgment. And court was also in the view that with the advancement of the technology, students should not be expected to be sitting in the libraries and taking notes. So obviously, it's the era of digital technology. Everybody tries to read and make notes of your digital notes, their laptops, their iPads. And see, we here at an academy are also using and leveraging the use of technology, making videos and bringing these interesting lessons. And it's kind of an education revolution. Obviously, nobody should be forced nowadays to go through, such thick books and make notes out of it. So that is, that was a task that the photocopy service was doing. They were making, course packs from the books, which are, sometimes very expensive, very thick to be covered. So they can just, bring the relevant topics and chapters for which the classes are going to be held that day, and they can reduce the burden. So that was the thing. And obviously, copyright is a statutory right and not a mutual right. And hence, any right that is granted to owners is also limited by exceptions carved out by law. So section 52(1) subclause 1 allows for the reproduction of any work and by teacher or a pupil in the course of instructions as part of the questions to be answered in an examination or in answers to such questions. Now, there have been certain references to an international judgment in this case. So there was a case, Cambridge University Press versus Becker in United States, which is obviously considered a very strict country for IP regime, and IP is a IP maximalist. The court held that the reproducing less than 10% of a book constitutes a fair use. And this case was regarding, related to electronic copies, the digital copies. So, but the same logic can also be applied and should be applied actually to the physical copies as well. And what are the implications of the judgment? So the positives, the positive is that, obviously it will give easier access to knowledge, and employment of labor for doing business of photocopy will generate jobs. Not too much, but then obviously, it's an informal sector, so it will generate a job. And less financial burdens on student, of course. They do not need to buy such thick books and such expensive books. And obviously, it will help students in rural areas where there is a dearth of knowledge, availability of books and availability of access to book is still a challenge for the students in rural areas. And what are the negative implications of the judgment? So this obviously goes against the intellectual property rights, and India has already been on a priority watch list by US against weak IP regime in India. And so the creativity also gets impacted, because the authors work really hard in making, preparing content. So they need some royalty and, reward for their work. So obviously it can hamper the creativity by the authors, and publisher may set higher prices for the books for getting better profit margin. And the loss of royalty, obviously, for the publishers. And there is a skepticism regarding the business ecosystem in India, that they have low IP regime and low IP protection in India. So what can be the conclusion of this case? So countries like India, where libraries and universities have to cope up with the need of thousands of students, and it's practically not possible for everyone to purchase a book. So in the era of digital technology, everybody, needs to leverage the use of technology, minimize their workload. They should not work hard, they should, work smart. So that should be the funda, obviously. So that is why, people should have this access, to get the photocopies, and, they should, reduce their workload. They can bring those photocopies, the relevant ones for which the classes are going to be conducted that day. Why to bring such thick books? There's no point. And they're so expensive. I'll give you my own personal experience. My optional is sociology, and there's one book, Holborn and Harlambo's very famous book, if you have an optional of sociology. It's not available in India, and it's a pretty thick book, and it's very expensive book by Indian standards for any optional. So if you have a photocopy available for that one, what's wrong in it? It helps in preparation for students, and it helps in access of knowledge. So that's my personal experience and my personal judgment on this issue. And obviously, IP regimes are meant to serve not only the private commercial interests of IP owners, but obviously a wide public interest. And IP rights also encapsulate a social contract in which the creator agrees to serve the public interest in exchange of legally guaranteed monopoly of his creation. But obviously, in many of the cases, IP owners breach this social obligation of serving the wider public interest by pricing the goods such that it becomes extremely difficult for a common man to afford it. So therefore, this recent judgment ensures that any literary work is not just benefited to the creator of the content and publisher, but also benefits the whole public at large, so that the new knowledge can be created while using the older one. So reproduction of knowledge, what's wrong in it? And copyright must definitely increase and not impede the harvest of knowledge. So that's the basic idea of this judgment and of this case. So we are still waiting if these publisher will go to higher court for appealing against this. Most probably they will, because they have the financial resources to go against this case. But otherwise, in itself, it's a landmark verdict and a landmark judgment. So this is it for this video, guys. Let me know what you think of it, and do let me know your suggestions in the comment sections below. Or if you have any other information regarding this video or some suggestions, you can do write to us on our email or in the comment sections below. So till next video, guys, have a good day, and thank you so much.